Good afternoon, my name is Alina Shevtsova. I'm an immigration attorney from Brooklyn, New York. In today's video, I would like to share with you some news regarding incoming, upcoming, very scary, right before Halloween, very scary changes to the H-1B program. And if you haven't subscribed to my channel, please subscribe and hit that notification bell button so you will stay updated regarding most current immigration news. So, what's going to change, perhaps, depending probably on the outcome of the presidential elections in the United States, what's going to change with regard to H-1B program? This one proposal that is going to be published very shortly is going to redesign completely the H-1B program in the United States. And you may be aware that H-1B visa is the most popular and probably the only most commonly used work visa in the United States. So what Department of Homeland Security came up with is to change the way H-1B petitions are going to be selected, to change the way the H-1B workers will be selected for the visas. As you may be aware, each year, there are more petitions for H-1B visas filed by employers than there are visas available. As a result, United States runs a lottery, just like a lottery for money. When you play for money, there is a lottery for those visas, okay? But traditionally, and all this time that, for example, I've been practicing for, which may be not that long, but 12 years, the lottery was random. Meaning that it would give a fair chance to a small employer and an employee whose wage level is not so high, and an employer who's a huge employer, like let's say Amazon, right, to have a fair chance between those two employers to compete for that H-1B visa in order for them to sponsor the worker they would like to sponsor. But this is going to be changed, according to DHS. Department of Homeland Security came up with a new way to select applicants. They stated that the new way is going to be based on corresponding wage levels, meaning that if employers are paying higher wages, they will be the ones selected. Their petitions will be the ones selected, leaving no chance to those employees who are going to receive smaller wages, right, lesser wages. And of course, I think that the impact of this rule will be that only huge employers like Google, Amazon, Oracle, those that dominate the H-1B wage scale, those who traditionally offer much higher wages to their workers. And by the way, those who sued the Trump administration recently when there was a H-1B visa ban, only those will remain in the game. Unless, of course, there will be some medium-sized or small-sized employer who can easily pay competitive wages that will be on the same level with Amazon and Google. It's a concern, and also I think this rule, I think, is also designed to eliminate the agencies, H-1B agencies that currently can also sponsor workers. But of course, how can you compete with Amazon? So proposed rules are going to be published soon, and then the public is going to have 30 days to comment. And after that, I guess there will be an announcement that the rule is going to go into effect. Hopefully, there will be changes. So maybe the administration is going to abandon its plan to change H-1B program this particular way. We will see. But for now, you need to be aware that this very well may be the reality in 2021 for someone who is hoping for an H-1B visa. And by the way, this new rules are going to be, if they're going to take effect, they're going to be applied for both level cap and H-1B advanced degree varieties of H-1Bs, okay? So master's degree and no master's degree, they both going to be subjected to these changes, okay? So thank you very much for watching. I hope that you find this news helpful. And if you haven't subscribed, please subscribe, like, share this video, and I hope to see you soon.